Okay. For LLM students, Pappus, who should never have been in the LLM class to begin with, we're going to talk about law and morality. Short notes. Okay, now these, you know, I like these subjects like law and morality, dharma, judicial activism, because, you know, you don't have to write any particular articles or even case laws. You can just write. You can just write and get on with it. Law and morality. Morality from the word morals, values. It incidentally brings me to another subject from Constitution of India called separation of law, separation of the state and religion. For those of you who will be appearing in Constitution, LLB, LLM, whatever, there is a question which will come up, the separation of religion from laws. Okay, we are dealing with a subject, law and morality. So, what is this question all about? What is the subject all about? Let's jump right into it. You know what is law? Law is an act of the parliament, okay, where the intention of the legislature is put forth and it is guarded by the judiciary. Law, you know, kanoon, niyam, kaida. So, you cannot murder. Why? Because that's the law. Okay? It's very clear. So you cannot murder, and that's that. Morality is what? Morality is what is sahi, what is galat according to people's thinking, according to a community's thinking, according to a religion's thinking. And there is a very robust debate between the need to separate religion and morality from law. For example, in United States, the founding fathers of the country were very, very clear that they will keep religion out, completely out of the constitution of the country. There is no scope for any religious element to seep into the constitution of the country. Thankfully, the architect of the Indian constitution did the same. The Indian constitution is not a Hindu constitution. It's not a Muslim constitution. It's a constitution steeped in law, where the rule of law applies. So, what's the difference between law and morality? This is the difference. If you break a law, you go to jail. That's for sure. You pay the price. If you break moral principles, you don't have to go to jail. Okay, you'll only have to be at the receiving end of opinion of the people. Simple as that. If you break moral values, you don't have to go to jail. You are not punished. You are not chased by the country, by the state. But if you break a law, you are liable to punishment. This is the first and the fundamental and the most important difference. Let's take a case in point. So what is the connection between the two? What is the connection between morality and law? At some point in time, morality decided the law. It still does. For example, beef. That's a dangerous word in the year 2018 in India. It can get you killed. It can also get you arrested. Cow slaughter is banned in very many states in the country. It's both against the morals and against the law. Sale of beef has been banned in the country. And this is a classic example of where law was formulated to be in sync with the moral values of the people. In Kerala, you can eat beef. In Rajasthan, you cannot. It's as simple as that. So what is the correlation between morality and law? The correlation is that oftentimes, what is morally acceptable is what is legally acceptable. Let's talk about alcohol. It's not illegal to drink in India in very many states. So in Goa, it's fine. You're not going to be arrested if you drink beer. But consumption, possession, sale of liquor in Gujarat and I think in Bihar is completely against the law. You will go to jail for selling, for buying, for consuming. Okay. So this is a fine example of laws that are different to suit different thinking, different society, different needs. Some based on morality. okay, some very far removed from morality. We will take another example from United States. In United States, there is this ritual called exorcism. Oh, there are so many movies where, you know, there is a ghost that enters the... Yeah, so many movies, yeah. So, in United States, exorcism is not allowed. United States believes that if somebody is acting hysterical or showing signs of being possessed, that person is mentally unstable and needs to be handled by the medical fraternity, not by the priests. Okay, whereas maybe there are other countries where exorcism is allowed. I don't know the position India has on this. So, when you get this question, law and morality, talk about the need for separation of law from religion. Talk about how morals became a source of law. For example, once upon a time in India, sati was celebrated. Okay, today it's illegal. The very act of sati will send you to jail. But once upon a time, the morals of those times were such that if a young lady becomes a widow, anybody becomes a widow, that lady had to jump into the funeral pyre of the husband and go along with the husband, accompanying him to the afterworld. If the lady was unwilling to do it, she was forced to do it. This is an act of morality, moral values. It was banned in India, thankfully, I think due to the efforts of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. And there are so many such examples that you can quote where there is a confluence of morality and law. Things change over a period of time. But please remember that modern law believes in the supremacy of the rule of law. I think Dicey, D-I-C-E-Y, from England. If you don't know who Dicey is, please get out. Dicey had once very famously said that in England, a man can be punished only and only for breaking the rule of law and for nothing else. So, if that person is guilty of violating a law, that person will be brought to justice, not for anything else, which meant that moral values have no place in modern welfare law. So if there is somebody in Goa drinking beer, he's not breaking any laws. You may be from Tamil Nadu and Kerala and you may be an orthodox teetotaler and you hate the sight of beer and you hate the sight of anybody that consumes beer. There's nothing you can do about it in Goa. He's not breaking the laws. Okay, so if you don't break a law, you're fine. You may be breaking moral codes. Let's talk about adultery. Adultery has been decriminalized in India today. The law states that adultery is not a crime. Morally, you may not want to associate with a man or a woman who is in an adulterous relationship. That's up to you. But you cannot anymore expect that person to be punished or brought to justice because of adultery, because adultery is not a crime in India anymore. Just like it is not a crime in the United States, it's not a crime in South Korea, it's not a crime in so many countries. It is a crime in Saudi Arabia. It is a crime, I think, in Pakistan. So, when you get a question on law and morality, write on all these points. Break them into small paragraphs. Okay, talk about morality. Morality originates from religion. Basically, what is right, what is wrong. Please touch on the subject that one man's right need not be another man's right. One man's right can be another man's wrong. So, the custom where an animal is sacrificed in one particular religion, which is, it's a duty of that man to sacrifice that animal in that religion, okay, he's morally required to do it, is considered to be a moral sin by a man of another religion. It's as simple as that. Non-vegetarianism, people eat non-veg, people eat meat. Okay, there are parts of the world where people have to depend on meat for their food. Okay, there are parts of India where such a person will not be allowed entry into the house. Now, these are moral conflicts. So, write about that. As long as you're not in conflict with the law, you're fine. You conclude this essay by saying that over the last 100 years, the world has moved from moral and religious based laws to laws as defined under the common law system, to laws set forth by legislature, to laws that uphold values that we call fundamental rights and that are uniformly applicable to everybody. In India, a lady has a right to vote, has a right to drive, has a right to be an equal to a man. In Saudi Arabia, in the year 2018, only now they have been allowed to drive. I'm not sure if they're allowed to vote. So, talk about all these subjects and do some more research, you'll be fine. Thank you for watching me. Bye-bye.